Welcome back to my channel, friends. This side Sonia here, and thank you so much for again being on my channel. If you have not subscribed to my channel, please do subscribe, hit the like button, and do press the bell icon cause so that you can get all the updates as soon as I upload any video or any post. So now today I'm going to do decoupage technique with mosaic, and for that I'm going to make a coaster. So I'm going to make one single piece of coaster. You can repeat the same process for other coasters too if you are making in a set of 2, 4, 6 and whatever the number you decide on with. So this is an MDF piece which I got recently from the market. So one thing which we all face problem with is that usually most of the MDF products, they have the stickers and how to remove it. If you just remove it, peel it off, it takes out all the base from that. So here is this trick. Use your heat gun or your blow dryer. Use it on your base like this. So I'm just going to run it quickly for say 30 seconds and then it will be super easy for me to take it out. So once I'm done, one thing, you should never ever use your heat gun on one surface only. Just keep on moving that. So yes, here I'm done, and now I can easily just peel it off. And now if you see, you can't see any mark on my base. So there is no mark that there was any sticker just few seconds before. Okay, so now this is done. I'll keep my napkin and other supplies aside because first we are going to start with our Mod Podge. Okay, so first we need to prep up our base, and for that I'm going to use my gesso, and it's an artistic gesso, and I'm going to apply this with my sponge dauber, and I am going to apply this on my complete coasters. You can use your paint brushes cause in this one I am going to use my decoupage technique, and it is going to be covered completely with my napkin, so even the paint brush is also fine. But I personally like sponge daubers a lot. You can choose the supplies what you want. Here I'm using gesso because like I have mentioned earlier also, you can use your acrylic paints too. There is going to be the difference in the look and feel of the project a bit. Just a bit, which is just marginal. But I personally like using my gesso a lot. And that's the reason I use my gesso and my acrylic paints also, but gesso is something which I use a lot. At times I feel, have I started eating gesso, because my bottle is like, my gesso jar is actually like finishing up so fast, because I use it on each and every tutorial in some other way, and I really feel that it makes your project really worth it and really beautiful. I'm just dabbing it a little more here and there, and I'm just making sure that I have a generous amount of gesso. And as you can see, like here I did not want it to do the coating for second time, so even with my first layer of coat it has not dried out, but still I'm doing my sponge dauber work, and this will make sure that it sticks well to my project. And I'm just trying to remove all the bubbles out there, and this is done. You just need to make sure that there are no patches. Your gesso has spread out evenly, and now I'm going to do my gesso on the sides with the same sponge dauber. I'm just spreading my gesso. You can take this gesso as and when you need. Whenever you feel that your sponge dauber does not have enough gesso, you can take a little amount of gesso and spread it.
à deux doigts de nos lèvres, deux doigts si fins que j'ai presque pu le goûter, le bonheur à sculpter de son ciseau d'enfer, des souvenirs impossibles à effacer. Le bonheur est passé à deux doigts de nos lèvres, deux doigts si fins que j'ai presque pu le goûter, le bonheur à sculpter de son ciseau d'enfer, des souvenirs impossibles à effacer.
Has dried out completely. My gesso has dried out so well and it looks really nice now. Now it's time to do the decoupage, and for that I'm going to use this napkin. Now if you are a revisitor of my channel, or if you have scrolled down to my channel, you must have seen this napkin which I had used on a wooden watch box, and I absolutely loved the way it had turned out. So I really liked that project. So since then I had kept this napkin that I'm going to use it on something really interesting, and I felt this is one of that interesting project. So this looks good, and now I need to stick this, but before that I need to apply my Mod Podge. Now I am using my matte finish Mod Podge, and I have just transferred it in a small container so that it does not dry out, cause I use my Mod Podge a lot on almost all my projects, cause I've been doing decoupage projects very often now, and that's the reason I've transferred it in a small jar. It becomes more handy for me and it becomes more easy for me to use it, and also it does not dry out. That's the most important thing, cause I have such really big containers of Mod Podge, and it dries out really in speed because I use them a lot, so most of the times they are open. Okay, anyways, now here I need to stick this one, so I will start with one corner, and now I'm going to just make sure that it's in a straight line and I don't have the plain edges. Now this tissue has some random border, so I'm just trying to make sure that that portion is out, and now even with my fingers I'm able to press this one because it's a very small surface. The coasters are of not that big size, so even pressing them with your fingers is super easy. Now once I'm done with this, I'm using my sponge dauber just to make sure that I have not left any bubbles or anything. So whatever it is going to press down well, and it is going to stick really well to my base. And now this looks really good. Okay, so first I will just close down my Mod Podge bottle, and now I'm going to trim this down. So I'm using my scissor here. I can even use my sandpaper or my nail filer to do the trimming work, but this is still wet, and on the wet surface you should not use your filer or your sandpaper to trim down the paper, because it is actually going to ruin your project. So just be careful about that. Okay, so now this looks good, and you can see that I have the white patch here, just a thin line. Don't worry about it, we are going to cover it with another supply. So now on this surface I am going to do some of my coloring and my stamping work, and before that I need to use my heat gun so that I can speed up the drying process of this napkin. Just make sure that you have pressed it really well, and if you have used the perfect amount of Mod Podge, the sealer, it works really well. Okay, so now it has dried out completely. Okay, so now it has dried out completely, and with my nail filer, this is one of the scrap nail filers which I always keep in my craft room so that I can use it for any of my decoupage projects or for some trimming work. And with this, I'm just going to remove all the extra papers. Just make sure that if this is your napkin, then you have your Mod Podge layer and then you have your base. So you should always start with your decoupage napkin side and take it towards your base. Don't do it upside down. It is going to take out your paper completely and ruin your project. So it should be always from your napkin to your base. And you can see how easily it comes out, and your edges look so neat and so clean. You can even use your sandpapers. They are also really good, but I find this one very handy, and that's the only reason. So it's not that I don't use sandpaper at all, I do use them, but this is something which I really like, and this is very nearest to my table. So when it comes to taking out supplies, I'm a very lazy person. I can chuck my supplies just like that because I was not having that feeling of going and taking so much of effort and taking out the sandpaper. So I do such things very often. Okay, so here in this side I have a very thin layer. Still I'm just brushing it up. So as you can see, this is such a thin area. And now here I'm going to remove this. You know, I've just realized that with the gesso, your texture changes completely. Earlier it was so smooth. Now it is smooth, but it has some very fine texture to it, which is something I really like. You don't get these textures with your acrylic paint. With acrylic paint, it's very flat. But with gesso, it works really well. Okay, so I'm done with my trimming work, and you can see that how my edges are looking so nice and good. Now let's just remove all the extra dust from my table. So here I'm done with these stuff. Okay, so my one side is done. I need to add up some color on the back side, and this has some really nice yellow, black, gray shades, and I thought of using this chalk paint for that. And I'll remove the packaging and I'll start with my shade. So I'm just making sure that there are no dust on my base. And do I need to seal? Ah, okay. Oops. Okay, so I'll use this one. I'll start using this one, then I'll see which one to go ahead with. And now I'm applying my chalk paint on this. Chalk paints are one of the, I feel, the basic needs of a crafter, especially if you are doing decoupage and painting work, and especially the recycling work. They are one of the best things to have, and they are super gorgeous, and they give some really nice and cooling effect to your project. I'll just throw this scrap paper, I'll close the lid, and now I'll start putting up some drop of color, and I'll use it on my tea coasters. Now this is the process. What I'm showing here is for the tea coaster. But if you want, you can use the same technique, and you can play around with the material and upcycle any of your stuff from your home, and you can redecorate them, give them a new look, and they are going to look gorgeous. And in case if you want, you can even play around with other kind of paints also. Like there are shimmery paints, there are glitter paints, there are metallic paints, and they all look so gorgeous, and they add some more extra touch, some really special touch to your project. So you can check those options too. Now here I'm almost done with my chalk paint. Yes, I'm going to have a good amount of chalk paint here because I don't want to see my base color at all. So I'm just spreading a bit more of color. Let me keep it on a bottle top so that it's easy for me to rotate my poster. Done. Now, as you can see, I have some of the extra chalk paints, so I'm just going to dab the same on the edges. And like I said, I wanted to add the similar color which is there on the napkin, so I chose to have this yellow color, and I think this is looking so nice and so fresh. This is more of a lemon yellow color, and this is looking good. I think using the paintbrush with my sponge dauber with my chalk paint would have been a much easier option, but I just started with this one, so I'm going ahead. But I would recommend that if you are doing this step, the chalk paint step, it's better you take your paint brushes so that it becomes easier for you and you can do it faster. So I am almost done. I'm just trying to make sure that I don't leave any patches here and there, and I just cover the complete area really well. So here I am done. Now I'm going to dip it in a bowl of water, and then I'm going to use my heat gun to dry this coaster. Step is to use my stamp, and this is another script stamp which I have. This is in some other font which looks really amazing. So this is my actually the really first stamp which I started, and it's been almost 7 years that I've been using this one. six and a half years that I've been using this one, and it's still as it is. Yes, there are some colors, but they do not make any difference because once I use it, I wash it really well and they are good to go. So yes, here I am using my Kavel permanent ink pad, and I'm just making sure that my each edges and corner has inks really well, and I'm going to have it till here only on the center part. I just press it so well, and ta-da, this is ready. Now on the sides, I'm just going to do some basic little stamping work, and this is just to make sure that the edges don't look dull and plain, and I'm just repeating the same stamp on the sides. So this looks so good now. And now before I start with my mosaic work, the 3D effect, first I'm going to give it a good coat of varnish, and for that I'm going to use my varnish and my flat paint brush, and this is just to make sure that I have a good coat of varnish on my base so that it is partially waterproof, and I can clean it really well later on. And I'm just spreading it well, so I'm trying to see from the different angles if I have not left any area here and there. Once I'm happy with this, then I'm going to start with the back side. Now you can do this one, back side varnish work at the end also. That's absolutely fine, but anyways, I am going to give it a good dry, so I thought I'll do it now only, and with that I'm going to save some time. So here I am using my flat paint brush. For varnish, I never ever suggest to use a sponge dauber because you are going to ruin that for sure. and it's always good to have your flat brushes. They give a good coverage for your varnish. I need to give it a good quick dry with my heat gun. You need to be really careful. Please do not overdo the heat gun in one area, and just be little careful because this is really hot, and you need to be a little careful when you are doing your crafting work. So as you can see, this area has almost dried out. Now one thing, whenever I do my varnish work, once I'm done with one layer, I just give it a quick dry and then I do the second layer, or I keep it for a day or two and then I do my second layer. But ideally the varnish takes at least 3 to 4 days time. For the more of layering work, you can do that, but when to start actually using the product, at least 10 to 15 days, because naturally it takes that much time for any kind of varnish to dry and absorb it in the base. So this is what I have felt, because initially when I started, I did few of the projects and immediately I started using it and I could see the change. And later on I kept my project for like say 1 week, 10 days, 15 days, and then I used it and I could see that there was no change in my product and no quality difference with the same material. So these two coincidences I'm telling you about are the same quality materials. So that is my suggestion, that I think you should take care and give some time for your suppliers to really set in there on your project. Okay, so my varnish work is done. For now it's done, because later on I'm going to add okay, now my first coat of varnish has dried out. It's time to have my second coat of varnish, and I'm doing this time just on the back side and the sides of my coaster, not on the front side, because anyways I'm going to do my resin work, and with one coat of varnish I think that will be good for me. So right now just one coat of varnish on the front and two coat of varnish on the sides and the bottom area. Okay, now again I need to use my heat gun. So here my two coat of varnish on the back side is done and the sides are also done, and on the top now I'm going to use this glossy accent, and this is actually a clear dimensional medium which is used on like your scrapbooking for your card making projects also, and I'm going to try this for my mosaic technique. Now I'll just zoom in my camera so that you can see my project completely. Now in this one I'm not going to cover all the triangles or the complete surface area. I'm going to have the random pieces, the blocks, the triangle blocks, or maybe I'll see how I am going to go about it. Now this one actually comes with this very nice fine tip, so which makes your work really easier, and you don't need to have any applicator or anything. With this you can directly use it on your product. So here I'm starting with this one, and I'm just going to go really gentle and really easy. Is done. So first what I did is I created a outline border and then I filled it up. I hope you all can see this is how shiny and nice it looks. Now again I'll show you how I did it. I took up a triangle, like for example if I want to use this gray, so here I just created a triangle with this accent, and then I will be filling this up with the same stuff. And as you can see, this was super quick and super easy. And the best thing is you don't need any applicator, you don't need to mix anything, you don't have to add anything to it, and this goes really, really well. Now I don't want, like I said, I don't want to fill up all the triangles in the complete coaster, so I'm just picking up the random triangles in which I want to fill it up, and I want to highlight. And this is so amazing. This looks really, really cool. I'm going to add few more here and there. Acha, one thing, whenever you are doing this, you need to make sure that you are going to keep your cup on this as it's a coaster. So you need to make sure that your cup size is usually this much. So I need to have a nice border on the side. So if I'm doing one on this side, I need to make sure I have complete thing on a circle or at least on a square basis, so that if I keep my cup, it does not topple and it stays in that position only, because that's the main purpose of our tea coasters. So here, let me cover up this yellow half also. Just a thin line border and you are really good to go and fill up the box with your glossy accent. So let me add some more here and there, and maybe this one. So this is one of the options like for filling up and to have your resin mosaic decoupage. Sorry, not raising your glossy accent, I'm too much into reason nowadays, I think. So that is there on my mind. Okay, so now this is one of the options on how you can create a nice mosaic feel and factor without even doing any cutting work. It is just that I have used my napkin and I have done this one. So I think I'll add this triangle also, and I'm just trying to make sure that I don't too much overlap these things. Like if you have seen my mosaic tray video in which I had converted a photo frame into a tray, I actually ruined that one because, not ruined completely, but it was not up to the mark because I had poured too much of resin, and that was my first time and I was not really sure that how it is going to turn out. One more thing, whenever you are doing this, make sure there are no bubbles, there are no air gaps, and even if you get some bubbles, just poke this and clear those bubbles so that it looks good. It does not create any bubbles out there. And this is done. And this looks really, really amazing. This is looking super, super cool now. I'll just tilt it a little bit. Show you all a quick tilt here and there, just to show you how shiny this looks. And now I am going to let it dry for at least 3 days, and then I am going to use this for my cup of tea. So with this, my tutorial is done, and I hope you all enjoyed this tutorial. If you have any queries, please do comment below. I'll try to reply that as soon as possible. Of course, I'm listing down all the supplies down in the description box with the links to buy them. If I don't get the product link of the exact same product, I try to find out, search it for you guys and put up the link which is very similar or which is the best what I could find out, but you can explore it of yourself too. But yes, I'm posting down all the supplies with the link down below. Do check that. And yes, please do not forget to subscribe to my channel. Click the bell icon and hit the like button. Thank you. Bye bye.